Hello, viewers and learners. I extend a warm welcome to the present module on collaboration and communication tools. With today's greeting, I am Professor Naseeb Singh Gill from Department of Computer Science and Applications and Director, Digital Learning Initiatives and Monitoring Cell of Maharishi Dayanand University, Rohtak, Haryana. At present, we are living in a digital age where students suffer every hour between smartphones, iPads, laptops, tablets, and MacBooks. We can now communicate with anyone, anywhere, anytime through the simple click of a button. And it is our job as educators to leverage these collaborative tools in the classroom. Many schools are finding creative ways to incorporate blended learning in their curriculums. Nothing is more frustrating to a teacher than lack of attention from students. Technology has been effective in eliminating this issue because it has redesigned the idea of collaboration and provided interactive learning opportunities. As discussed in the previous module, among different types of digital tools, collaboration and communication tools are occupying vital importance and role in the virtual world for their unique characteristics. Sometimes distance and time may become a big problem for individuals and organizations to conduct group activities. This module highlights the conceptual and practical understanding of collaboration and communication tools as distinct type of digital tools and explains how these tools are affecting teaching and learning experiences. So first of all, let's outline the learning objectives of the present module. And learners will be able to understand, number one, relevance of collaboration and communication tools. Number two, characteristics of collaboration and communication tools. Number three, types of collaboration and communication tools. Number four, use and relevance of popular tools such as Google Drive, Skype, and G Suite. Number six, essence of online discussion forums, social media sites, blogging, Padlets, video conferencing, and podcasting. So now let's step forward and understand about collaboration and communication tools and their role in digital learning environment. Collaboration and communication tools help people to collaborate, communicate, and exchange information among different individuals and group members. The purpose of these tools is to assist a group or several individuals to meet a common target or agenda. This is concerned with different types of software, mobile apps, and online services that allow people to communicate and collaborate regardless of their physical location in real time over the internet. It offers web-enabled applications and software that provides services such as prompt messaging, appliances and tools for file sharing, collaborative platforms and search engines for group members. These tools are basically concerned with collaborative work environment where individuals cooperating take care of the issue, produce an item or extract relevance from a collection of material. Now, let's understand the significance of these tools in the field of education. These web-enabled tools empower faculty and learners to carry out extensive variety of activities, including interactive discussions, online collaboration activities, sharing and accessing e-learning resources, and many others. It's basically referred to perform various tasks, share and access the resources, participate, discuss, and perform online activities. Before getting into depth of these tools, now let's learn about the characteristics of collaboration and communication tools. There are various characteristics of these collaboration and communication tools. It can be something as simple as email and as complex as sophisticated project management software. These tools are quite user-friendly. These tools reduce dependency on email. These tools save time, cost, and energy. These tools enable individuals or groups to have discussion in real time and to form a thought with easy access. This provides opportunity to each member of the group to contribute and promptly share own idea and vision in preparing concepts, reports, and proposals with the group and immediately receives feedback. These tools help to sustain the central notion together, and people may work together on word processor documents, PowerPoint presentations, discussion groups, and web conferencing, etc. Examples of these tools include Gmail, Google Drive, Skype, video conferencing, social media, discussion forums, Padlets, blogging, podcasts, and so many others. Now we take some live examples of some popular collaboration and communication tools with practical orientation and exposure. In this sequence, let's first take up Google Drive. You can access Google Drive at the website drive.google.com. Google Drive is nothing but a free web-based application and data storage service offered by Google. It facilitates users to store, create, and share online documents and edit them collaboratively. It allows users to quickly and easily share and collaborate on files. Google Drive offers word processing, spreadsheets, presentations, and Google Forms as most important features of communication and collaboration tools. Now let's discuss storage features and security features of Google Drive, which are highly needed in the present scenario. Let's have a understanding of storage features of Google Drive. You can upload 750 gigabytes of data per day. You can upload files up to 5 terabytes in size. If a single file exceeds 750 gigabytes daily limit, that file will be uploaded. Subsequent files will not be uploaded until the daily uploading limit resets the next day. Now, let's know about security features of Google Drive. There are primarily 5 main security features. Number 1, storage in the cloud. In case your computer crashes or hard drives fail, your document will still exist in Google Drive. Number 2, network protection. Communications between Google Drive and your computer are encrypted to prevent people from eavesdropping on your documents as you edit or read them. Number 3, authentication. Authorization of Google provides insight how to specify a good password for your account and prevents unauthorized access to your documents. Number 4, privacy by default. Only your account has access to the file when you create a new file in Google Drive. Number 5, automatically tracks changes. Google Drive automatically tracks changes to the document, allowing you to revert back to previous versions if an unwanted change is implemented. Now let's pinpoint few don'ts of Google Drive to avoid risks. People should avoid these, such as they should not share a file with unintended party. They should not go for setting insecure permissions and sharing context or visibility to a shared document. An unauthorized party accessing your Google Drive should also not be allowed. They should not upload a document that is inappropriate for Google Drive. They also should not share a document with another party that is reshared by that party to an unintended party. If Google experiences an outage, you may not be able to access your files until service is restored. Now let's learn how to use Google Drive to share files, folders, photos, pics, and videos. Google accounts don't have to use Gmail address, but a Google account gives you access to Google products, which includes Drive, Documents, Sheets, Slides, Forms, etc. And you can associate any email address with a Google account. First of all, you have to have your Gmail account. If you don't have it so far, please visit the website www.gmail.com and create your own Gmail account. After creating the account, now let's proceed further for the brief tips for using Google Drive. Here are the few steps, and you can have this live exposure for creating a Google account as well as for using your Google Drive for uploading and for downloading files and folders. Number one, step number one, there are two ways to access Google Drive. Using Gmail account, number one. Number two, using the website, and that is drive.google.com. And once you click it, you will get an access and the path in the browser, drive.google.com/drive/mydrive, which you may see in the snapshot. Step number two. So now let's locate Google Drive. If you are using Gmail account, then you notice the arrow in the corner of the snapshot that points to a grid, which represents Google Apps, which is shown in the red color with a pointer. Press this grid. You will get about a dozen of Google Apps icons. And if you want to have look at more apps, then you notice there is a button more at the end of these apps. So you may press this more button at the end of these apps window. You will be served several other apps too. Have a look at. These are the other apps. Now locate the drive icon, which is three color and triangular in shape. You click this drive icon and you will be served the same window as you obtain when you log in through the website option by visiting website drive.google.com. Step number three. Now you can create your own folders and subfolders in Drive to organize your documents or files depending upon their nature and type. Step number four. You can also download email attachments. And email attachments could be the PDF file, pics, document files, forms in the drive. So what you have to do is, you have to open the email having attachments and bring your mouse pointer on the attachment as you are noticing on the screen. It will show you two options. First with down arrow and the second with drive icon. Have a look at on the screen. Now what you have to do is, you have to press the drive icon. And after pressing it, you have to select the folder or subfolder in Drive, where you will find several options in the Drive where you want to download the attachment. You may also create a new folder for downloading the current attachment if you want to store the present attachment into a new folder which do not exist at the moment. Step number five. Similarly, you can also upload the attachments. Could be your PDF, pics, movies, documents, forms. So attachment could also be uploaded from Drive to your email as attachments. So for selecting the files from the Google Drive as an attachment, first of all, what you have to do is, you have to go to the bottom bar while attaching the file, while in your text window. You see a triangular drive shape icon. What you have to do is press drive icon on this bottom bar. You will be served Google Drive, where from you may choose any document from any folder or subfolder. After selecting it, press insert button and the same file will be attached to your email. So this is what we have learned, that how to use a Google Drive for downloading a file or for uploading a file. Now let's learn more about Google Drive. What are the access levels of Google Drive? Who can access it? And what are the authorization and authorities to access Google Drive? There are four access levels within Google Drive. First is owner. Owner is having the full control for access. Number two, editor. Editor is having authorization to edit a document, to add or remove users by default. A editor cannot delete a document, but an editor can download or make a copy. Third level is for commenter. A commenter can read only with ability to comment and also can download or make a copy. And fourth, access is for viewers. Viewers can read only and they can also download or make a copy. So now let's sum up the present module in a nutshell. In this module on collaboration and communication tools that we discussed, we have covered several tools, primarily the tool that is Google Drive, how it is meaningful for us. I hope that you would have enjoyed this module, and we will soon join you with another module on collaboration and communication tools. Thanks a lot for enjoying and for your active participation in this module.